Hello everyone, I'm Rekha Murthy, Assistant Professor from the Department of EEE, SVIT College. Now, related with the DSP lab, I'm going to discuss about the experiment number 5. So that experiment 5 is related with the computation of endpoint DFT of given sequence and to plot magnitude and phase spectrum. So before we start to compute the DFT of any given sequence, what is a DFT? It is the discrete Fourier transform. Discrete Fourier transform, which will be mainly used for performing the frequency analysis of discrete time signals. So DFT gives a discrete frequency domain representation, whereas the other transform are continuous in frequency domain. So how do you write the endpoint DFT? Endpoint DFT of a discrete time signal x of n is given by the equation, x of k is equal to summation of x of n into e to the power of minus j 2 pi by n into k into n. What is the variable here? N. So you need to write n is equal to 0 to n minus 1. What is the variable here? K. Again, k also starts with 0, 1, 2, etc. up to n minus 1. Okay, now this is about the DFT definition. So here the input will be the given the sequence for which the DFT is to be computed. The second thing is we have to identify the input. The input will be the length of the DFT is required here. Okay, and we need to compute the DFT by using the for loop. Then we have to plot the magnitude and phase spectrum. So how to write a program for this experiment? So as the mathematical expression given, okay, x of k is equal to summation of n is equal to summation of x of n into e to the power of minus j into 2 pi by n into k into n. The same thing will be written in the MATLAB. That is x k of k plus 1 is equal to x of n plus 1, right? So both the side, what we have to do, we need to increment by 1 times, because the MATLAB cannot understand the index with the 0. So we have to start off with the index 1. So therefore, this will be written as xk of k plus 1, x of n plus 1, convolution with the e to the power of minus or exponential. So we have to use exponential of minus j into 2 pi into n into k divided by n. The same mathematical expression what you had written, same thing we have to write it in a MATLAB, in the instruction. And here we have to take up the same value which you had taken in the LHS, xk of, rewrite that xk of k plus 1. So what is the value of xk of k plus 1? So again it will be initialized to 0, right? Xk of k plus 1 will be initialized to 0. Then we have to compute the DFT. This DFT can be computed by using the for loop. So let us write to the for loop for this variable, that is x for k variable. So therefore we will write the for loop for this, for k is equal to 0 is to n minus 1. Similarly, after when this k execute, then only we can execute this line. So again one more for loop I have to enter. What is that variable? N. So therefore we have to write here for n is equal to 0 is to n minus 1. See this, for n is equal to 0 to n minus 1, you can't include it here because this value cannot be executed. So it should be step by step. So first we had initiated this value to be 0, then what is k value we had initialized by using the for loop. Then finally we have to take for loop for this n variable. So we have taken n is equal to 0 to n minus 1. Why we are doing this? Because the summation of n is equal to 0 to n minus 1, we have to execute one. And another loop is for k is equal to 0 to n minus 1, which will be written here. Okay, so this for loop will be here and the another for loop will be for this. Okay, now, so we need to end when. So after executing this, we have to end this loop. Okay, then we have to obtain the value of xk of k plus 1. Xk of k plus 1, then we have to end this main for loop. Now which are the input variables? So it may ask you the question with this including the for loop, what is the n? N will be nothing but it is the input. Enter the number of points. So how much the length will be given. So that n point, n can be, will be equal to 4 or it can be equal to 8. Okay. So similarly, what is the next variable which is going to ask is x. So what will be the x? X is nothing but again an input which we will provide you the sequence. Enter the time sequence. Okay. Now this is the main thing which you have to remember to write a program. The remaining steps and all are similar what you had followed in your the previous 2, 3, 2nd, 3rd experiment, right? So here we need to next include the plot. Okay, so we have to plot the three graphs. We need to plot the three graphs. Okay, one will be the magnitude spectrum, the another will be the phase spectrum. So to calculate this magnitude spectrum or a phase spectrum, so we require the two graphs, right? So along with that, you can also include the another input as x. So totally there will be three graphs. Okay, so now we can take up the graph in this manner. One graph will be responsible for the magnitude of x of k, and another graph will be for angle of x of k, another value will be for your x of n, the input which you had given. So this initialized with first graph, right? This is the first column. This will be the first column. How many plots are there? 1, 2, 3. Three rows are there. So wherever you write a subplot, three times. So the instruction will be rows, how many rows? 3, comma, column, 1, comma, the first graph. Let me number, this is your first graph. So you write first here. So that first graph, it leads to give you the value of stem n, comma, to obtain the magnitude, we are going to use the keyword absolute. Abs of xk. Okay, then x label, what will be the x label? X label will be k value and y label will be the magnitude spectrum. Okay, or you can say magnitude of x of k. And then title will be the magnitude spectrum. Okay, magnitude spectrum. Now here which all the variables which again it will be keep asking as an error. So what is that value? Here we need to execute this for n is equal to, because here n will be the unknown thing. So again it will be asking, did we had declared n variable here? No. So you need to declare here itself. N is equal to 0 to 1 is to n minus 1. So this plot will be ready. Second plot, how to write second plot? The same instruction you have to write, but only the thing you have to change this statement. This statement gets changed to subplot of 3 comma 1 comma 2. This will be for and stem. Stem of n comma angle xk. Okay, and these are all the same thing. Instead of y label, you have to write angle of xk. And title is phase spectrum. Similarly, this plot is over. Next plot, how do you write? Just it is an input. Again, subplot 3 comma 1 comma 3. 3 comma 1 comma 3. The same thing we have to write. Okay, and new variable you can include, because these are all with respect to n. That variable you can include it as n1. So this is how, if you remember these steps, you can easily write the program for this experiment. And when you give the input sequence, okay, when you give an input sequence, finally you obtain the value of magnitude and phase spectrum, but theoretically you need to verify the result which you had obtained with the simulated result.